Hello all, welcome back to my channel. This is Dr. Sonia Musakuti and today I will be dealing with a very small topic called halitosis. We all know that the common term that we use for this halitosis is bad breath. The term halitosis is derived from Latin word halitos meaning breath and osis means abnormal. The presence of halitosis is usually an indication that some abnormal condition exists. So, next we can discuss about the causes of halitosis. It includes both oral conditions and odors from the systemic disorders. The oral conditions include retention of food around the teeth, gingival and periodontal diseases, deep carious lesions and necrotic pulp, coated tongue, mouth breathing, poor maintenance of appliances, oral soft tissue and hard tissue lesions, smoker's breath and dehydration state. So we will go through each one of the oral conditions one by one. The retention and putrefaction of the food within the oral cavity is the most common cause for halitosis. The next is a gingival and periodontal disease. The saliva from individuals suffering from periodontal and gingival disorders putrefies rapidly. The presence of periodontal pathogenic microorganisms contribute to increased production of volatile sulfur compounds. In case of chronic gingivitis, the bad breath is due to the chronic gingival bleeding with strangulation of blood clot in saliva around the inflamed gingiva. The next oral condition associated with halitosis is poor maintenance of appliances. Dentures and appliances, if they are not kept clean and hygienic, causes accumulation of mucoid deposits from saliva and food debris, and putrefaction of these deposits produces a characteristic pungent odor. Next comes the mouth breathing. This is due to dryness of the mucosa during sleep with mouth open, secondary to malocclusion. The oral soft tissue and hard tissue lesions can cause entrapment of food particles in and around them, and they hamper proper maintenance of oral hygiene procedures. This debris get putrefied and causes tense breath. Next is a smoker's breath. The person who is a chronic smoker and use tobacco snuff regularly or burnt tobacco for teeth cleaning procedures typically have a dry, pungent, disagreeable odor of stale burnt tobacco emanating from the mouth and also from the lungs. Next, we can discuss the odors from the systemic disorders. These include odors from nasopharynx, pathological conditions of lungs and bronchi, disease of gastrointestinal tract, metabolic diseases, blood disorders, salivary gland disorders, aromatic substances and drugs. Certain forms of atropic adenoids, chronic bronchitis, sinusitis, nasal polyps, postnatal drip and tonsillitis, pharyngitis etc. are frequently accompanied by foul odor. Chronic bronchitis, bronchiectasis, lung abscesses, pulmonary tuberculosis, malignancy etc. can also produce a typical disagreeable breath. The diseases of the GI tract like gastritis, peptic ulcer causes sore breath due to bland diet and also causes coating of the tongue. In case of metabolic diseases like diabetics, which gives a typical acetone breath due to the presence of ketones. Uremic breath is present in cases of uremia and chronic kidney disorders due to excessive presence of urea and creatinine. Chronic liver diseases like cirrhosis and malignancies causes tense breath which is disagreeable. Some of the blood disorders like anemia and agranulocytosis causes bad breath. Leukemia and thrombocytopenia cause bleeding around the gingiva and this infected blood clot causes foul smell. In case of salivary gland disorders, xerostomia and absence or lack of saliva prevents cleansing effect of the teeth and oral mucosa and causes bad smell due to food debris entrapment and their fermentation by oral flora. There are some drugs which have an indirect effect on causing halitosis. Isosorbitrate dinitrate, which is used for angina pectoris, atropine-like drugs, diuretics, long-term steroids, antidepressants etc. cause xerostomia, lessening the cleansing effect of saliva. Next we can go for the investigations of halitosis. There is no special treatment or simple chemical test which can reveal the presence and intensity of halitosis. Various means like osmoscope, cryoscope, measurement of surface tensions of liquids, measurements of hydrogen ion concentration have been used to determine the intensity of odors. Sniffing at close range from the patient's mouth or nose is a simple diagnostic method. Offensive odors originating from the nose indicates a local cause within the nose or its sinuses. If the odor originates from the mouth, it may be due to local causes in the oral cavity or throat. Next, we can go for the treatment of halitosis. The source of halitosis should be determined first through history, complete examination of the oral cavity, nasopharynx, oropharynx, and with proper and systemic history. Local oral cavity odors requires thorough prophylaxis with elimination of periodontal pockets, food retention areas, treatment of oral infection, hard and soft tissue lesions, etc. Patients should be taught correct method of toothbrushing, tongue cleaning, and interdental flossing. Use of aromatic dentifrices and antiseptic flavored mouthwashes reduce the foul odor. After food and drink, the mouth should be rinsed thoroughly to avoid any remnants of food debris around the teeth. The patients who are using dentures and appliances should be advised to keep them clean and hygienic. The patients with history of mouth breathing should be advised to use mouth screen at night during sleep. Advising a balanced and nutritious diet with less fatty food and regulation of garlic, onion in food or regulation of alcohol intake, tobacco use, smoking usually help in regulating foul odor in the mouth. If no oral cause is found for halitosis, history and examination findings correlating with patient's sign and symptoms may help in diagnosis of systemic cause of bad odor. So that comes to an end to the today's topic, halitosis. I hope all of you found this video useful and interesting. Thank you.